Hi, my name is Spencer, and today I'll be reacting to Star Trek Prodigy, Season 1, Episode 19, I believe. I believe this is Part 1 of 2, and I'm excited to get into it, I guess. I don't know, I mean, this season has been a lot of fun, a lot of things to enjoy here. I'm just sad that it's coming to a close. But I am very excited to see what's going to happen next, how they're going to get out of the predicament that they have found themselves in from the last episode. Last time we had a body swap between Dahl and Janeway. They were finally able to communicate with Janeway to let her know, like, hey, we can't communicate with you traditionally because of the living construct. There are consequences that we do not want to inflict upon you. And she understands, and she also was able to learn some things about Chakotay while she was on board. But while Dal was on the Dauntless, he ended up just totally making Janeway look very untrustworthy. So I guess we'll find out what's going to happen with that next. The Protostar is now in Federation space, in the middle of Federation space, surrounded by a ton of Federation ships. And if the Living Construct wants to do the most damage, the Living Construct would probably just hail everybody and try to communicate. Like, you would think that if the Living Construct can, like, move the ship, lock them out of the controls, you would think, since it has full control, that it would be able to open a comm signal or whatever itself. Like, Hopefully that's not a plot hole that comes up. I mean, I don't want the Living Construct to destroy the Federation, but I mean, it doesn't seem like there's anything to stop it from happening. So I guess we'll see. But before I get into this, don't forget to like this video if you like it. And if you have anything to say about this episode or the previous episodes, please put it in the comments. Also, if you're not currently subscribed, but you like this kind of content, I would appreciate it if you would consider subscribing. It really helps me to stay motivated to get these videos out in a timely manner, and it helps the channel to grow, so thank you. I don't believe I have anything else to say before jumping into this episode, so I will go ahead and do that.
If any one of our fleet opens a hail, we'll receive a hostile signal designed to turn us against ourselves. In the blink of an eye, this entire armada will devour itself. You must release me.
Well, you're in a predicament.
Good thing Admiral Janeway can set this straight.
About that. I may have tarnished her reputation a bit.
They think she's crazy. I'd be surprised if they believe anything she says.
And how would they know they're in danger?
They won't.
Get a team on that ship.
Yes, Admiral. Fire phasers, take out their shields.
Why is the Protostar not answering hails? Why doesn't it just answer the hails and let them destroy themselves?
Software blockade. All it takes is a hardware reconfiguration.
What?
We hotwire it.
It's one way to do it.
Then shift that auxiliary power from the core to boost our shields.
Oh, great! That Jacob can do!
I thought it was going to complain for a second there.
Other ships are targeting us now!
Gwyn!
Well, they all have their orders.
We've been in worse jams with less practice. Trust me, we're going to laugh about it one day at Starfleet Academy.
Well, better hope so.
Leave their luck when we join.
Right, Brock? Oh.
Right.
Exactly. They may...
Yeah. They don't want to tell. They don't want to tell him. Disappoint him. But I swear, Janeway can vouch for him if they can just believe her and believe that she's medically stable. Mentally stable.
Jacob calls that maneuver the Slippery Dipsy Doodle!
Great work! Except for that name.
True. Not a great name.
You're wrong, Admiral. I do know you. Back when you commanded Voyager? You lied to the Devor people when they were searching for illegal refugees on board.
Yes, the refugees were innocent and unarmed. That was a long time ago.
Not to me.
What?
I know you don't recognize me. I was much smaller then, but I was one of those Bernari refugees you helped escape through the wormhole. I'm alive because of you.
Nice.
Glad to have met you again.
Nice. Okay, well, still no one's gonna believe her, even though she's been let free.
Gwyn, where are you going?
To give us a fighting chance.
How?
If anything happens, I want you to hear this from me.
You should tell her that your dad helped you. That her dad helped you. Ooh. Okay. I mean...
I'm so sorry. I thought that was a moment and we felt the same.
Kind of awkward, but okay.
Starfleet won't allow Hawkins.
What?
When the Admiral was on board, she told us. I'm sorry. You deserve the truth.
I mean, you could still try, though.
Warp and impulse offline! We're defenseless!
Dal, what are you doing?
You can still stand for Starfleet, though.
But if I can't join Starfleet, I'll make sure you guys can.
Well, okay, I guess that's an option, but... I mean, you could just try. Shooter. Well, Starfleet's not one to ask shoot first and ask questions later.
All hands on deck. Do not let them reach the bridge. Gwyn, seal the doors and don't let anyone in.
Not even your dad.
Multiple targets acquired.
Freaking Dreadnought, man. He's cool, but annoying. Thought that we're supposed to...
Follow emitters, Starfleet override, ensign, ascensia.
You can't do this.
She's an ensign. How does she have authority to do that?
Check to see the weapon is intact.
Well, there must be a way to deactivate it if they have a reason to check on it.
Uh-oh, gravity mine!
Oof. Crushed by rock. Wouldn't affect Dreadnought, would it?
In time, I'm sure he'll forgive me.
Well, they both have their own weapons.
Target eliminated.
I already know this is gonna leave on a cliffhanger just because it's a two-parter, but still. It's gonna be so frustrating. Rip, get wrecked. Taunting him. Dang. Either set it to full blast or set it to explode on itself. What's Janeway doing in the meantime?
Open hails! Do it!
Is he not gonna do it?
This was mine!
You were always the weak one.
No!
Lame.
No, don't answer that hail!
Too late. Everyone's probably answered now. Well, that sucks. I'm sure something will work out by the end of part two. Right? You would think.
Starfleet's destruction is our salvation.
Well, a lot of people are gonna die. Maybe if he makes a big grand gesture towards Starfleet, they'll let him in. Okay, melting him out. Nice. Okay, now get to the bridge. I mean, not like you can stop what's already happening, but we'll see. Go ahead and shoot Ascensia. Knock her out.
You'll pay for it.
Aw, maybe, but not today.
Just shoot her already. There's no reason not to. Well, they just punch a hole through, yeah. Okay, I wasn't sure if they did or not.
Closure activated.
Quintana. He might know a way to turn it off.
My Quintana.
Quick, tell us how to disable the thing. What? Does this happen to them when they die? Is this a normal thing? Is this energy gonna do something?
What's going on? Did we stop?
Nope.
Jankum, get me a damage report.
Our hull stabilized, shields returning, we're banged up, but Scutch Nahala Fritz come up by heel.
Speak in words I can understand.
Uh-oh.
The construct is impeding our universal translators.
Nahaba! Torbim!
Dang. That stinks.
This is your admiral. Prepare to abandon ship.
That's all you can do.
Abandon ship.
Karskat Shonashov.
Oh, they don't understand you either.
Quick,
everyone, calm down.
I'll see if I can circumvent the firewall and get translators back.
Please.
Shouldn't their badges at least be on an independent tech thing? Circuit? And translate still? She knows different languages. She can translate, I think.
Oh,
haha.
My father had me study languages to pit.
Nice.
Stand by.
The bridge is yours. Okay.
Nice. This is nice. I like this.
And why should I help?
Because in the infinite of space, everyone needs to know. There is a place out there willing to accept us all, no matter how different we think we are.
Well put.
Starfleet needs you now, or it will not survive.
Well, all you can do now is hope.
I need to evacuate our ships.
I mean, no one's targeting the Protostar. Just get everyone on the Protostar. I mean, it's a lot of people, but still.
Admiral!
Oh, well.
Brace for impact.
Nice.
Prepare to beam out.
Nice.
Ooh, and a civilian Zurok class? A Gorn trading vessel! Bulk freighter and... Oh, a Decora. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Jacob understands you!
Oh.
Nice.
I only helped. You did the communicating.
Nice.
It appears Starfleet's defense protocols automatically emit an SOS when in dire threat.
What does that mean?
It just keeps... Yeah, it just keeps going.
Are compromised. Even more ships will come.
Dang.
It's annihilation.
Is that it? Yeah. Dang it. That's so annoying. I knew it was going to end earlier than I would want it to, but it's okay. Have next week to look forward to. Dang. I don't know. I was thinking, like, you would think that if the Protostar crew can bypass the control of the ship through the hardware, like, if they can hotwire the ship, then you would think that Starfleet officers would have the know-how to do that as well. But it's not really the same sort of infection that is taking over all those other Starfleet ships. Like, this was... Like, what was hurting the Protostar, or controlling the Protostar, was was not the virus itself. It was just hijacked separately, like in a separate way. So you would think that, I don't know. So I guess that would explain that confusion on my end, them not just being able to bypass that. I guess Essentia is just gone for now. My guess would be that she is going back to her planet, maybe not in her timeline, but just go and live a quiet life on their planet. Rest in peace, the Diviner. That was, I don't know. I think he did redeem himself in the end there. I wish he could have told them, like, hey, this is how you disable the living construct. But I think even though it was his mission, or even though he loves Gwyn and wants her to be happy, there was still a part of him that, like, it wasn't enough to make him stop the mission completely, to go against the mission. But he did want her to unite people in the end there. So I don't know. I'm sure he just didn't want to waste his last words to his daughter on, here's how you disable the living construct and save everybody. Yeah. I'm a little confused as to why no one's firing on the protostar itself. Like, you would think that it's still a Federation ship. Maybe the living construct has got some self-preservation algorithms or something. I don't know. I saw it coming, like the whole doll having feelings for Gwyn. I mean, who's to say if she reciprocates? But hey, I mean, he went for it, and good for him, I guess. I don't know. I just, like, I was very reluctant in my mind to be, or to think of these characters in sort of romantic ways with each other, you know? It's just, they're kids. I don't know. It's hard to, I mean, it's like, I understand though, like they have crushes and they can have a crush on each other, and I don't know. Maybe it'll work out for them. Maybe it was probably just bad timing for Gwyn, because she was going to tell him some bad news, and it's not going to be good timing until this is all resolved for them to hash out whatever feelings there are, if there are any feelings for Gwyn. But I mean, takes guts. I admire Dial for putting himself out there. But it's been sort of a long time coming. There's like, it's been implied and that he's had feelings for her, especially in the last episode when the Diviner let Janeway go. Janeway. And Dahl was like, you know, I would do anything for her too. So it was sort of implied there. I mean, it was definitely implied there. I didn't want to say, like, oh, that's definitely a romantic feeling he's feeling, because you never know. It could have just been like best friend type of thing. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad that Janeway was able to be freed by this former refugee that she helped in Voyager. I do not remember that episode off the top of my head. Voyager was the first Star Trek show I watched all the way through, so that is, like, all the memories I have of Voyager are, like, the big things that happened, the really weird stuff that happened, but everything else is the furthest from my mind, because it that's the first show that I really watched. I think I can remember things about Deep Space Nine more than I could Voyager, just because that's a little more recent. But even so, it's been years since that. So yeah, like I said, didn't really remember that plot line from Voyager, but I appreciate the reference, and I think it was just a great way to let her out of the brig. Yeah, I'm not sure why the living construct needed Essentia to be on board to open the comms, you know? Like, it had full control of the ship before the Protostar, like, hot-wired, took back control somewhat. Like, it could have easily just, as soon as it arrived, broadcast something. Like, it doesn't need a command to do that, right? That's my biggest complaint about this, about the logic of this episode specifically. Like, couldn't the living construct have done that on its own? But also, I mean, I guess it makes sense that, I mean, it would have been, to me, it would have been hilarious if that had happened and Essentia was trapped on the Dauntless and being fired at and probably destroyed. I mean, I'm sure Dreadnought could have done that escape pod thing and jetted off the ship like they did, but still, it would have been really funny for me to be like, haha, you get a taste of your own medicine here. But yeah, who knows why the living construct didn't just do its thing. Also, my comment earlier about, oh, there must have been a way to disable the living construct, otherwise they wouldn't have sent the Diviner to go check on it when it was revealed that Essentia just sent him down there to keep him out of the way, because she could tell that he was not fully on board anymore because of his daughter, or that he would show some weakness because of her. If it happened, it would have happened off screen, but I hope that Admiral Janeway would have sent out a broadcast to the rest of the ships and been like, you guys need to abandon ship because there's no fighting this. I mean, I'm sure they could probably, like, come to that conclusion themselves, but, you know, before too many people get hurt trying to stop what was happening to the ships. They really liked how they talked to non-Federation or non-Starfleet vessels to get some protection. I really liked that aspect, and I really liked that Gwyn was able to communicate for that. I don't know. I was just thinking about it just now, but you would think that Starfleet, like, with even with there being universal translators everywhere, you would think they would require some sort of language, at least for most people to learn standard, but as a part of the curriculum. But unfortunately, I don't know. It also seems a bit it doesn't sit right with me that they would just be like, they'd be like, haha, join our human organization and learn human so that you can, yeah, I don't know. like expecting someone to learn another language just because they join us. It's like asking someone, like, who immigrates to America that they have to learn English, which I don't think is right. So, but you would think that, I don't know, like, you would think that Starfleet would plan for, in case there is a time when universal translators don't work and that they have to all have to speak one language, like, they would teach multiple languages and people would be able to communicate like that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't call that a plot hole. It's not a criticism. I'm just being a bit nitpicky, like, huh, you would think, maybe, but maybe not. Yeah, I mean, I was sad that the Diviner passed away, that he died. And I don't know, it kind of annoyed me how easily Essentia was able to deflect the Diviner's heirloom weapon, or whatever it's called. I don't know what it's called. I'm sorry if I'm saying that wrong. His weapon. I was kind of surprised that she was able to have control over it, or maybe not control over it, like its form or whatever, but like it was easy for her to deflect. But maybe that's just their species can deflect, or they have special training for those kind of weapons. So it's not that big of a plot hole to me. It was just kind of like, really? I wanted more of a redemption from the Diviner, more than what we got. But I'm glad, I am grateful for what we got. I really liked that in the end, he stood up for his daughter. I'm glad that they could have like a moment at the end there to reconcile. Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure how this is gonna get resolved in the next episode. I'm not quite certain where this is in the timeline. I don't know. Like, this has gotta be before Picard, right? I'm gonna check real quick. Wait, okay, this article says where it fits in the timeline. Let's see. 2383, it says, when is Picard? 2399. So it is before Picard. So obviously, I mean, even with just knowledge from Discovery, with them going hundreds of years in the future, like, the Federation still exists there. So the Federation, obviously will still exist after the next episode of Prodigy. So something's gonna have to happen to prevent the total destruction of the Federation. I have no idea what it could be. I doubt it, but I guess Q could show up and snap his fingers and get rid of the living construct and stop this from happening. I doubt he would, but I doubt they would do that. The Borg is not friendly with the Federation yet, as of Picard Season 2. So that's not going to be the solution. Yeah, I have no idea. Like, I hope that... Well, okay, so my best guess is that... And this doesn't have to do with the logistics of how it's going to happen. This is just... My best guess is that the crew of the Protostar will figure something out. Will have some idea, and they have the time to think about it, because as opposed to other Starfleet, like people who are actually in Starfleet, because they're all worried about evacuating and not being destroyed, the Protostar is sort of in a safe space right now, which gives the crew of the Protostar the opportunity to come up with a plan. And this would be the best case scenario, in my opinion, is that they would come up with a plan to stop the destruction of everything, and then they're successful, and then Starfleet's like, oh, thank you crew of the Protostar, I'll let you join Starfleet, even you, Dal, you are a hero. Best case scenario. But worst case scenario, I mean, obviously there is no worst. The worst case would be that Federation is destroyed. That's the end of the show. And we know that's not possible. So also in the best case scenario, they would find a way to get Chakotay back and all of that. But yeah, I am not optimistic about Chakotay. I think that they've changed the future enough that it would be a different timeline. And although somehow Burnham's mom showed up in Discovery Season 3 after having changed the timeline and she already having been in the future, you would think that, I don't know. It's very, the timeline thing is so confusing. The time travel, man, time travel. I just hope that Chakotay has a way to return. But I don't know. I don't feel super optimistic about it. And one of you guys in the comments said that, like, you know, like, why would Robert Beltran return for this character that he was unhappy about? Like, about the way that how it ended with him or whatever. I don't know the details of his relationship with the role of Chakotay. You would think that he wouldn't want to return just to get killed off, but I mean, there was Han Solo. Like, Harrison Ford didn't like being wanted to be killed off, and they killed him off. So I don't know. Maybe Robert Beltran is done. Maybe he's tired of... I don't know. I really don't. And you guys can tell me how that is with Robert Beltran and Chakotay. Please, inform me on that, because I don't know. I have little hope that he is returning, personally. You guys can have the hope for me. I have a slight glimmer of hope that he will return to the past, and who knows? We'll see. There's a lot to resolve in the last episode there, and I don't think it's going to be any longer than the rest, the other episodes of the season. Like, it'll still be like less than 30 minutes of an episode, so I don't know. We'll see. There's a lot to do, a lot to resolve. I don't know. I was kind of at the end of this episode, I was kind of hoping that it, like, this whole living contract thing would get resolved, so then we could just deal with Chakotay in the next episode and Starfleet and all that, like them joining Starfleet in the next episode. But it doesn't seem like we're gonna have enough time, you know, like, with just these short episodes. Like, what could they possibly do in 24 minutes that resolves the living construct, Chakotay, them possibly joining Starfleet? I don't know. We'll see. I just hope it doesn't feel rushed, and that it's a solid conclusion for the season. I'm pretty sure there's going to be a season 2, so I really hope that it's a good bookend for this season and sets up for next season. Maybe next season will just be them in Starfleet, or next season will just be them going to save Chakotay or something. Not that these kids have any sort of connection or desire to save Chakotay, but who knows? I don't, so... but anyways, let me know what you guys thought about this episode. Let me know what you guys think about... let me know what you guys think is going to happen in the next episode. What are your theories? I don't know. Let me know what you think just about everything in general. Don't be shy. But I really appreciated this episode for what it was, even if I want more. This is a part 1 of 2, so obviously they're gonna leave us wanting more. But I'm excited to see what happens, and I don't know how this is going to resolve. So yeah. But thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys and your continued support throughout this season of Prodigy, and I hope that you will stick around for the last episode. I mean, why wouldn't you? But thanks for watching, thanks for being here, and hopefully I will see you guys next time.